Buffy. Hey.
We're at Buffy. Sit. Yes, good girl. Spin. Yes, good girl. Sit. Pull. Yes! That's my smart girl. Yes!
Hi. And say hi to YouTube. They're here to see ya. Say hi.
Buffy.
You ready to go to the groomer? No. You want to chew on your shoes? These are her designated chewing shoes. I was going to donate these, and she said, nope, I want it. So she's munching away. But all right, Buff, we got to go.
Got to tell the people I have to carry you down the steps because you don't know how to go down yet, and you're getting heavy. So we got to learn, right?
Today, I'm wearing the men's gray jogger set. I live it. I live for it. I love it. All right, we're late. Come on, Buff.
And, yep, nope. Buffy, good girl. Good girl.
All right, we just got to the groomers. 5 minutes to spare. You ready? You had a good ride, Buff? You ready? You ready to get all pretty? Okay.
She is over me. Here we go.
Mask is a must. You ready? Come on. I'm a mother. My goodness. All right. So I just dropped Buffy off at the groomer. I didn't realize they said it was going to be a 2 to 3 hour situation. Interesting. But I just dropped her off. She's getting like a bath, a little nail trim. I think they're going to brush her teeth, all that good stuff. Listen, I tried my best to give her a bath the other week. She has a lot of hair. So she looks big and like thick. But really, it's just the hair. She's only like 9 or 10 pounds, but she has so much hair. And I was trying to like shampoo her. Just couldn't get up in there like I wanted to. So I was like, yeah, that's a no for me. I'm going to drop you off at the professionals. But yeah, I didn't realize it was going to be several hours. So I'm going to grab a bite to eat, a little coffee, and we're going to sit and have a chat and answer all of the questions that y'all have been asking me over on Instagram about the Buff. Buff the puff, Buff the body. I'm not sure if this is a New Jersey thing. Well, I'm in Pennsylvania, technically. But I'm going to go to Einstein's Bagels. And then I'm going to get my coffee from Starbucks. Let's do it. Great. I'm back. From Einstein's, I just got an egg and cheese on a French toast bagel. And from Starbucks, I don't think I've ever ordered this. I got a nitro sweet cream cold brew. I don't know why it's so light, but I'm concerned. I've never ordered it, so I don't know if that's correct, but I don't know. I really feel like people watching is one of my actual favorite things to do. Even though I don't like to socialize, I just like to watch. All right, but I want to answer some of the questions that I've been getting over on Instagram about Buffy. So first one, what is her breed? Buffy is a Chow Chow. They're not super common. I actually don't think I've ever personally seen a Chow Chow in person until I got Buffy. So they're just not a common dog that you see around. And then going off that, another question I got is what made me choose a Chow Chow. For years, I've been wanting a dog, but when we started working from home because of the pandemic, I like seriously started researching what kind of dog I would actually want. And when I was doing my research, I really made my decision based off kind of temperament and the dog's personality. I knew for me, I wouldn't do well with a dog that has an energy level that's like always on 20. always wants to play, always all over the place, always just like, you know, all over the place. I wouldn't do well. And then of course also the puppy, it wouldn't be fair to a puppy for me not to play all, you know, 24/7 when they want that attention. So if you're not familiar with the Chow Chow, based on my research, kind of concluded that they're very independent. They typically don't like to be bothered a lot. If they wanted to play, usually I would have to initiate it. Typically, they're just to themselves, very independent. And I just felt like when I was reading up on it, it sounded like me, but in dog form. So I was like, perfect, perfect match. Of course, other breeds that are like that, but I just fell in love with the Chow Chow and how she looked. And I thought that it would be a great match for me and what I needed and wanted out of a dog. So that is why I chose a Chow Chow. And so far, that seems pretty accurate. Most of the time, she doesn't want to be bothered with me. She's just chilling, napping in the corner, playing by herself. If I try to get into her space, she literally is like... But then again, every once in a while, she does like to play. How big is she going to get? So yes, Chow Chow, she's very tiny now. She's 9 pounds. Right now, she's only about 12 weeks, but she will be big. Chow Chows can range any place between like 50 and 70 pounds. I feel like she might be on the smaller side, but let me not speak too soon. I don't know, she could be ginormous. But yeah, she's going to be a big, big dog. So over these next few months, you guys are going to see her go from a tiny little, tiny, tiny, tiny little dog to a full-grown beast. Please answer my next question. Buffy currently is 12 weeks. How's Buffy's potty training going? It is actually going really well. When I initially brought her home, of course, she was kind of peeing everywhere because she had no idea where she was or what was going on. But when I got her home, really the past few weeks, she's only had like one or two accidents, which is shocking for a puppy. But the beauty of working from home is that I have the time to walk her every hour. And then we gradually moved into every 2 hours, and she's still great. She's adapted really quickly and learned really quickly to potty training. So I got lucky there. And the last and the biggest thing that I think people were curious about is how I got Buffy. Interesting story. Like I said, I have wanted a dog for years, but with working a 9-to-5, literally leaving the house at 8-something in the morning, not getting home until 5-something, and then on top of that, still having to like go to the gym and run errands, I literally had no time for a dog. It would have been grossly irresponsible to get a puppy. So that's not something that I wanted to do, and it just wasn't an option. And then lo and behold, the pandemic happened and they sent us home. When we first went home, I was like, oh, maybe this is a good opportunity, but I'm still laughing at back in March when we all thought we were just going to quarantine for 2 weeks. So I think the first half of the pandemic, it was just kind of like the unknown. Like, are we going back in 2 weeks, another week, a month, another month? We all just didn't know what was going on. And then fast forward, here we are 7 months later, still quarantined. So about halfway through, when I realized, yeah, this is getting bad, we're probably not gonna go back for the rest of the year, that's when I started researching the types of dogs based off of what I wanted. And then I landed on the Chow Chow, and I started like aggressively looking to get a Chow in the tri-state area, and I couldn't find one. My heart was set on a Chow, so I didn't want to settle for another puppy or another dog, because that's just truly what I wanted. But in New Jersey, there was none. New York, Pennsylvania, I would have even been willing to drive to go get one. But I spoke to someone at the American Kennel Club, and they were like, yeah, no, nobody has puppies up north right now. So I kind of gave up on it. Lo and behold, I went down to Florida for Thanksgiving. I hadn't seen my family in over a year because of the pandemic. So I made the decision to fly down for Thanksgiving. By my mom's house, there is a pet store, and I kind of just went on a walk and I just popped in just to see what was going on in there. And there she was, this perfect little Chow, just chilling, waiting for me. Sorry, I had to switch locations because someone started blasting music next to me. And there she was. And I was like, no way. And I immediately was like, don't even try it. You can't bring a puppy on an airplane. It's just not gonna happen. So I just played with her there and I left, and I just sat and thought about it. How I make decisions, for me, it's always just very calculated. I've been wanting to do it for months and it hasn't happened. And then all of a sudden, boom, right in front of me, the dog I've been wanting, perfect. Walked out, and I kind of just sat for like an hour. Like, you can do it. Like, you can get a puppy. And I was like, no, can I bring it on the airplane? I can't bring it on the airplane. That's not even realistic. No way, they're not gonna let me do that. And I called the airline and they were like, of course you can bring the puppy on an airplane. It's gonna cost you. But yes, you can absolutely bring it with you on an airplane and it can sit with you. And I was like, this is way too easy. It's like interesting, just in life in general, when you're trying to like force something to happen and it's just not that time yet, then all of a sudden it's just presented in front of you and you're like, it's happening. The stars have aligned. There she is. She's perfect. They said I can bring her on the airplane and the rest is history. It's interesting how the universe moves with you when it's time for something to happen. I know I'm getting like deep and looks like overthinking, but it's something that I've wanted for a while. I just went to Florida and that answers another question. I got her in Florida. She was amazing on the plane. I was literally shaking. I like had anxiety about bringing her on the plane because I just knew she was gonna freak out. This puppy was knocked out the whole time. The whole time. She just sat and slept. Didn't even know what was going on. She woke up when we got to New Jersey and she was just chilling. So that's Buffy's story of how I got her here. And the last question I'll answer is why I got a dog. So yeah, sorry, to answer that question, I just wanted a dog because I genuinely love dogs. It was perfect timing. Like, I'm single, I don't have kids, I'm working from home. I have nothing to do but to give this puppy all of my attention and love. But also on top of that, I think I made the decision and I was really looking during quarantine because it got rough, I think probably for most of us. And I just felt like I was waking up every day with like no purpose. And I was waking up every day feeling like I was on a hamster wheel, like literally opening my eyes, turning on my work computer, working till 5, logging off. Gym was closed most of the time. Waking up every day feeling like you have nothing to do, nowhere to be. It became a lot mentally. And I just knew like getting a puppy at this time would have been perfect. Now I feel like I wake up and I have a purpose. This quarantine has been rough. That like hamster wheel of like nothingness and just feeling like what is going on? I think I needed her more than she needed me, for sure. And it just feels like a new chapter and I'm so excited for her to spend the rest of her life with me. So yeah, that is the story. I'm gonna go check on Buff. We're approaching 2 hours. Hopefully she's behaving. Let's go check on the Buff. Look at your bows. They say you were a good girl. They say you were a good girl. Look at your bows. You got your nails cut. You smell good. You ready to go home? Ready to go home?
Are you mad, Buff? Are you mad at me? Because I left you there with those strangers?
Her haircut. You see it? You see your little bows? I don't know what they were thinking. Let's take these out. Are you pooped? It was a long day. I know. She's usually had about 3 naps by now, so I know she's super, super tired. For some reason, the bathroom floor is her favorite place to nap. I have no idea why. Maybe because it's cool. But yeah, look at that. Look at that face. Buffy.
All right, so to wrap up this video, I know a lot of you guys were saying that you wanted a puppy and you know what to do. One pointer I just want to give, I think there's a huge misunderstanding with understanding how much work a puppy or a dog actually is. Especially this time of year, people like to gift dogs and puppies as if they're stuffed animals. They're not. It is like having a child, like a kid. Like, I can't move the same way that I used to move and without thinking about Buffy. Like, I can't just go out for hours on end. I can't sleep until noon like I'm used to doing. She needs to go on at least 3 walks by then. I have to have eyes on her literally 24/7 to make sure she's not getting into anything that she shouldn't be. I think people just grossly misunderstand the amount of work it takes to have a dog. So whether you're interested in adopting or shopping, first of all, just make sure you do your research about the kind of breed that you want.
Don't just pop in somewhere and be like, oh, that one's cute, I'll take it. Like, actually do your research to see if that type of dog with that type of temperament that needs a certain amount of maintenance and attention, make sure that that works for you. And I just can't emphasize enough to make sure you have a clear understanding that having a dog is not easy. They require a lot of time, attention, and money. And I think when people get puppies, they're all excited because they're these tiny little cute little 5-10 pound dogs. Within a matter of months, that animal is going to be full sized and they're going to be out of that kind of cute phase, which is when people kind of just think it's too much, no longer want the dog, they give it up, etc. So I did just want to emphasize that if you want a puppy, just make sure you do the research. Understand it's not easy. It is like having a child, like having a baby. And if you're not ready for that commitment, I would recommend you just not do it.
I'm trying to close the YouTube and she wants no parts.
So with that being said, that is going to conclude Buffy and I's vlog today, even though she doesn't want to be bothered with me anymore. If you have any questions, feel free to ask down below. You will see Buffy in probably all of my YouTube videos going forward. I'm so excited for this new chapter, and I know a lot of you guys are excited as well. But that's all I had for you guys today. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have an amazing week. Look. Say thanks for watching. Look. Say thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Bye-bye. Wave. Say bye. Oh, ow. Okay, bye.